A big field, goalposts, a pond, and more benches and trees.
They shouldn't build any gray schools. They feel so lonely. They should be bright and colorful.
Fewer cars, because the exhaust that comes out of the back is unhealthy, and it's bad for the environment.
And it's not just the children at St. Catherine's School in Hamburg who want more greenery, better buildings and fewer cars. The city has embraced those aims too. Over the next decade, Hamburg plans to slash greenhouse gas emissions by 40% compared to 1990 levels, a target far more ambitious than that of most European cities. But Hamburg is not an idyllic backwater. It's a large industrial center and its harbor a major transport hub. So a lot of people are asking how they aim to achieve these objectives. With lots of individual projects and by everyone doing their bit, according to Enno Isermann. He and his colleagues from the city's development agency were behind Hamburg's successful bid for the title of European Green Capital 2011. Running this solar-powered boat doesn't harm the environment. Since last summer, it has been plying its way across the Elbe River, silently and exhaust-free. It's ideal for tourists who want to enjoy Hamburg without causing pollution.
It helps us, because it demonstrates in a practical way that you can make do without coal and nuclear power. There are a lot of projects springing up and people saying they want to take part. That's one of the main ideas. The whole city is meant to join in and show we can live in a green way.
Working in an environmentally sustainable way is also important. This office building is in the Hafen City development down in the harbor. It's covered by a translucent membrane which allows as much light through as possible but prevents too much heat buildup in the summer months. So it's an alternative to energy-intensive air conditioning.
The Hafen City project has given us the opportunity to develop a new neighborhood from scratch. From the start, we placed great importance on meeting certain environmental standards. The strictest one is the gold standard. That means this building consumes only 15% of the energy used by a normal office building.
Hamburg favors showcase architecture with the highest environmental standards when commissioning public construction projects. The city also wants to reduce emissions by encouraging citizens to take to their bikes. But a lot of people are still unwilling to do so because the cycle lane network is still underdeveloped. And a broad-based network of groups called the Future Council criticizes what it sees as the lack of a sustainable transport concept, even in the newly developed neighborhood. Jochen Menzel has written a study on the issue.
Sustainable mobility is about favoring non-motorized transport. That means pedestrians and cyclists. The Hafen City has been designed and built around the car. The cycle connection to the inner city is pretty much a catastrophe. Either you have to cycle in the same lane as the cars, or over bumpy cobblestones or wooden planks. It's far from a smooth ride.
But Hamburg has shown a radical pioneering spirit in other areas. This hill to the south of the city is a former rubbish tip, with a solar and wind park on top. The facility provides 2,000 Hamburg homes with green electricity. It's hoped the idea will catch on.
If we want to solve the CO2 problem, then we're going to have to do it in the cities. And turning a rubbish tip into a public place with a regenerative energy plant is one example which should be copied around the world. It's the right step on the way to climate neutral cities.
Harnessing the sun and wind on top of an old rubbish tip. Just one of the many projects needed to achieve Hamburg's ambitious climate goals.